Good morning, everybody. Mark Finan here in the Home Weather Office on this Friday morning. It is now the 26th day of July 2024. This is the morning briefing. Mostly what I'm going to be talking about today is the park fire, and also going to be talking about the cooling that has started. You may have felt that this morning, but I'll talk more about the cooling that we will see and the impact that may have on the fire as we go through the next couple of days. The fire now, let's see, the last estimate I had on it here was 165,000 acres, something like that. That number, of course, is quite flexible and will continue to go up. Anytime you hear those numbers, that's just kind of a snapshot of the last time you heard it. The fire, of course, continues to grow. A little perspective on that. The Mosquito Fire, the biggest fire we had a couple of years ago, it was only 76,000 acres. Caldor was 221, Dixie was 963,000. So this fire will continue to grow and will likely be bigger than the Caldor fire later on today. It'll likely exceed 200,000 acres because it continues to burn. So let's take a look at what it looks like on the satellite this morning. A couple of things going on here. The fire is burning on a few different fronts. You have this area to the north. Actually, let me stop the animation here because with the sun coming up, it's just a little bit annoying. All right, so we have the fire burning here. This is the part that's burning north into Tehama County, into Tehama County. And this part of the fire is mostly burning in grassland. And then you have this area that is burning along Highway 32, and then this area, and this is more into the timber in Butte County as you get up around 2,500 to 3,000 feet. So the fire is burning on a couple of different fronts, and of course sending up that huge smoke plume, and we will likely see this part of the fire burn hotter as we go through the day. As a matter of fact, let me just try something real quick. Let me go over to the fire temperature, if I can find that. Fire temperature. I was looking at this earlier today, see if this comes up for us. Because what it clearly showed, yeah, here it is. So this is how the heat is being detected by the satellite. And this is the area that's burning along Highway 32, and you can see it's burning hotter than the area that's burning in the grassland. So the timber burns hotter than the grassland does, the lower elevation. And this will still continue to grow and advance north toward Highway 36, but it's this area along Highway 32 that'll likely be the area of biggest concern as we go through the day today. So let me talk a little bit more about what we saw yesterday and what the area that we are talking about. So what we saw yesterday, what we saw happen yesterday, if you're watching on KCRA, you were able to see this quite dramatically. So here's Highway 32, and you notice that it's up on a ridge. So they're not just trying to protect Highway 32 because it's a road. It makes it convenient because of access, but it's also a ridge. So the fire was down in this drainage on Big Chico Creek, which runs right in here, and the wind goes parallel to that in the afternoons usually. And the fire also likes to go uphill. So that's what happened last night, yesterday afternoon, is it went uphill toward Highway 32. And if you're watching the news on Channel 3, you saw quite clearly that this area of homes, I believe this is called Woodward Park Avenue, something like that. This area did look as though there were homes that got involved here on this side of Highway 32. So the fire raced up this hillside and got into these homes. The last pictures we saw last night, the homes on this side, I believe that's called Eagle Creek Drive or something like that. It looked like those homes were okay as of like 6:30 or so. And then if you look farther up the road on Highway 32, this is Forest Ranch. And as you can see, there are homes and businesses, and there's a school up here, all on both sides of the road. So this is going to be a big priority during the day today. I do not have any morning intelligence on where the fire progressed into this area during the night last night. But if I back out a little bit and talk more about just what the firefighters are going to be trying to do today is they're going to be trying to hold that ridge. They'll also be doing structure protection in the Forest Ranch area if they can. But if they can keep it in this drainage, the thing that they don't want to have happen is to have it go over into the next drainage into Little Chico Creek. because then you would, instead of having to defend this ridge, you're looking at the next ridge over, because if it gets down into this drainage, it will follow the wind and it'll go straight up this ridge. So then you'd be looking at the next ridge over, which has a little bit less access, and then you get into more homes. And then if you go over one more drainage, then this is Butte Creek, and you do not want it to get into Butte Creek, because then, well, on the other side of Butte Creek is Paradise. Now, Paradise is just fine right now. Paradise was put into an evacuation warning. In other words, telling folks there just to be on the lookout. And there, of course, there was the fire that burned here, the campfire, of course. And this is the way watch duty shows. Let me back this out a little bit, because a couple of things going on here. Here is the approximate footprint of the fire. Right in here, this is the approximate footprint of the fire. And then these are evacuation orders and warnings. Some of you correctly pointed out yesterday, they also use yellow for power outages. I took that off just because it was so confusing. But what we also have on this layer are fires within the last 5 years. So this is the imprint, the footprint rather, of the Dixie fire. And then this was, I forget the name of this big fire that burned all the way down to, this was a complex actually. I forget the name of that complex that burned all the way down to Lake Oroville. But these are happening in the last 5 years. But what you don't see here is the footprint of the campfire, because that burned more than 5 years ago. So what is likely to happen is, here's the fire perimeter roughly, and along Highway 32. And so what we're likely going to see happen today is more growth out in this direction, off to the north and to the east. And if it continues to grow, it'll eventually get into this area that was burned by the Dixie fire. And that would certainly slow it down. And then farther to the north, the area along Highway 36, I think there's another road up here that they will also try to defend before it gets to 36, but we'll likely see more progress in that direction as well. And it's all because of, well, the wind that we're going to be seeing today. We are going to see the winds pick up a little bit. This is the wind first thing this morning. Let me fast forward to this afternoon. This is 2 o'clock this afternoon. And while the winds aren't exceptionally strong, it's plenty. And these winds will be channeled straight up those canyons that I talked about. So in other words, that wind will be going parallel to these canyons. Even though the models may show winds going this way, or maybe this way, by the time the wind actually gets here, the winds in the afternoon get channeled straight up these canyons. They don't, in a case like this, they don't go across the canyons. They generally go straight up. So once you have fire established down in here, it will just continue to go up. As a matter of fact, I can show you the way that looks on one of the, not that one, this one. I can show you the way that looks on one of the cameras this morning. And this is a camera from the Alert Wildfire camera. And let's see, which one did I call this? I think this is Colby. Oh, there we go. Put this into motion. And this is the early morning. And you can just see how that wind is going parallel to the canyon. So the fire is burning down in this canyon. This is right along Highway 32. But you can just see everything just going parallel to that, even though the prevailing wind may be the other way, or slightly askew from that. What we're seeing is the wind kind of go parallel down into the canyons. And so what they don't want is to have it get over into this next canyon and then be moving along in that direction as well. So with that wind, let's talk more about that wind. That will be increasing this afternoon. That'll be venting the fire. So I'd expect to see some pretty rapid progress on that fire again in those areas, especially on the north side of Highway 32. And firefighters will be hoping it doesn't get down into any of the other canyons. And then at 5 o'clock, this is the wind that'll help to really cool off the valley as we go through the day today. Valley temperature staying in the 90s today, and it will be even cooler as we head into the day on Saturday. This is late tonight, and actually that wind turns into more of a southeasterly wind. I don't think that's gonna have much impact on the fire. But then on Saturday, the winds will be almost the same that we're going to be seeing during the day today. This is Saturday afternoon, south winds that'll turn into southwest winds going up those canyons once again. But the temperatures will be lower and the humidity will be higher, perhaps helping to slow down the progress of that fire just a little bit. Let's talk a little bit about the cooling that's coming in. With that, I'm going to show you the temperatures around 5,000 feet. So this is this morning, and 5,000 foot temperatures are up around 24 degrees C. There's a little low that's going to go by, so that by the time we get into late tonight and early tomorrow, this is tomorrow afternoon, instead of being around 24, those temperatures are around 18. That helps to keep our valley temperatures in the upper 80s to around 90, some of the coolest weather we've seen in more than a month. And even on Sunday afternoon, we're seeing the same thing with temperatures around 18. So we could see both days this weekend perhaps stay in the upper 80s to around 90. The average high for this time of year for Sacramento is 95. We're still in the hottest part of the year. That doesn't start to drop off until we turn the calendar to the month of August. But either way, July will be the hottest month we have ever seen, and we'll probably do that by a couple of degrees, which is pretty big. When you look at average temperatures for the month, usually if you're looking at records, you break it by a couple of tenths. We're going to likely break the record for the hottest month that Sacramento has ever seen by a couple of degrees. So when you get your electric bill for this month, yeah, it's going to be huge if you haven't gotten it already, as well as the impact that the hot and dry weather we've had this month has contributed to the drying of the fuels and the fire conditions that we're seeing in the state. So the wrap-up on the park fire is today is going to be a critical day. The winds will be increasing this afternoon. Firefighters are going to be trying to hold Highway 32 and hope it doesn't get over from Big Chico Creek down into Little Chico Creek, because again, they're just going to have to defend another ridge. So I think that's going to be one of the main areas of focus during the day today, and just hoping for the best in Forest Ranch. Again, I'd love to know what happened overnight last night in Forest Ranch, but I think that's going to be an area of focus and concern there today along Highway 32. But for all other locations, we'll continue to see the smoke get vented out to the north, so we won't see any smoke impacts in the valley, and temperatures will be quite a bit cooler over the weekend, so it'll be much more comfortable. But yeah, I think today is going to be a critical day for the park fire. I'll try to do an update this afternoon around 3 or 4 o'clock as we do get more information and as we get into the biggest burning part of the day, which is the hottest part of the day around 3 or 4 in the afternoon, and as those winds pick up. So hopefully I'll have an afternoon fire update for you later on today. In the meantime, make it a great day. I'll talk with you later.